you've been strengthening your research muscle and making progress on your research paper. It's starting to get easier because you've been doing your research workout. Thumbs up. Now you'd like to gather information on a topic. You've created a research question. You've identified the likely information types you need and which search tools to use. Now it's time to begin your journey with search. You wonder, why is it important to search strategically? Can't I just start putting words in the search box like I do with Google? You could, but then you'll get so much information that you won't be able to determine if it meets your needs. Information overload. That's why strategic search using several keywords tied together with Boolean operators is important. Let's explain this a bit, all right? When you enter words into a search tool, such as flu shots, mandatory doctors, nurses, you are telling the search tool to search for items that contain all of those keywords. The search tools use an implied and to combine all terms, flu and shots and mandatory and doctors and nurses. That means it will return everything with all of your keywords, even if an article or source has nothing to do with doctors and nurses getting flu shots. But if you want specific information related to doctors and nurses getting flu shots, you'll need to narrow your search using Boolean operators. So let's get started. Narrow your search. And is an example of a Boolean operator. Boolean operators are words you can use to connect your keywords systematically. As you add more keywords, the number of documents that contain all of the keywords is going to diminish. Let's look at a real-life situation.
Hello.
Hi.
Can you help me, please? I've been trying to find research on my topic, and I can't find anything. I have to turn in my sources in an hour.
Sure, I'd be happy to help. What is your topic?
Advertising and elections. I've tried every possible search term, but I keep getting no results.
How about you go ahead and log into EBSCOhost and show me what words you've been using.
EBSCO, okay. I tried negative advertising in elections, negative ad elections, and even advertising elections. None of them got me anywhere. See?
Okay, but the thing is with our library databases, phrase searching doesn't work very well. So what you'll need to do is you'll need to use Boolean operators. It's okay, it's not that bad. What Boolean operators are is you take three different words, and, or not, and you use it to separate the terms in your phrase to get the results that you want. The most common one is and, where you'll be looking for this and that in a particular, for your subject. And say, for instance, that you were wanting to do a search on the cherry industry in Washington State. What you could do is you could do a search for cherry and Washington, but you'll also get, in addition to everything about the cherry industry, you'll get stuff with George Washington chopping down the cherry tree. So what you can do then is you can use another Boolean operator, not. So you can go cherry and Washington, not George, and then everything having to do with George Washington is going to fall away. There's even another Boolean operator, or, which you could use. So say, for instance, you weren't just looking at the cherry industry in Washington, you were looking at the apple industry as well. Then you could do Washington and cherry or apple. Or is pretty much used when you have two like words or when, you have very similar topics.
Well, that's good and all, but getting back to my topic, advertising and elections.
Sure, let's go back to the database. I have a couple of keywords in mind to start with. How about we do advertising and election? And you'll notice I put that Boolean operator and in there so that we get articles that contain both concepts.
Wow, that's great, but I don't have time to go through 1,200 results.
How about we go ahead and narrow the results by adding another term? What would you suggest?
How about concentrating on negative advertising elections by adding the terms and negative.
OK, Okay, this is great. We've got 129 results right now, and we could probably narrow it down more, but how about we go ahead and start with these?
Wow, this is nice.
But if you really want to get specific, you'll need to add some punctuation. There are several punctuation tricks you can employ in your search strategy. Putting quotation marks around words tells the search tool to search for those words as a phrase. For instance, when you enter flu shot in parentheses, instead of searching for everything flu and everything shot, you are searching for the phrase flu shot. Check out how phrase searching using quotation marks narrows your results. Flu shot with quotation marks in Google yields 5,140,000 results. In the library search tool, it yields 8,539 results. Flu shot without quotation marks in Google yields 12,700,000 results. And in a library search tool, it will yield 51,787. Influenza vaccination with quotation marks yields 498,000 results in Google and 18,040 results using the library search tool.